Hi, I'm Sharon Maclis at IDG Communications, here with Do More With R, color-coded calendars. One of the best ways to see if you're meeting a daily goal is a simple calendar with color-coded squares. Did you meet a daily business metric like sales or social media posts? Or how are you doing with personal goals like daily exercise? R can help. Let's take a look at a calendar that tracks daily exercise, more specifically, whether you did cardio, strength training, or rested that day. First, you need to get the data before you can visualize it. For simple data entry, I usually use spreadsheets, either Excel or Google Sheets. I know, a bit of heresy coming from an R enthusiast, but I like to use an optimized tool for a specific job. Here's how you might set up an Excel file for daily exercise. You can see I've got a column for day and a column for activity. But what I don't want to do is freeform enter text into the activity column. I may think I'll remember that the exact format for strength training is strength training and not weights, but I want to be sure. So I'll add data validation to my activity column. I set up a column of acceptable options in another tab. See, I've got cardio and strength training. Next, I'll select the cells where I want to restrict data entry, in this case, the whole activity row except for the header. I'll click on the row and then deselect just the header cell. Then I'll choose data validation in the Excel data ribbon. Here's the data ribbon, data validation, and select list instead of any value. Finally, I'll click inside the source field and then go to my possible activities tab to select my two choices. I've got cardio and strength training, and click OK. Now my spreadsheet is set up correctly. If I want to add another entry, I'm given two choices. Let's pull down this to get the next date. And then if I click in this field, you'll see a drop-down list. I can choose cardio, and it pops in. I'll save the file. And finally, it's time for some R. To make an easy color-coded calendar, I'll use the ggplot2 library and the ggcal package by Jay Jacobs. Ggcal is on GitHub. You can see the code to install the package here. I'm not going to run it since it's already installed on my system. I'll load ggplot2 and ggcal. I'll also load dplyr because I almost always end up using dplyr whatever I'm doing. Read Excel to read the spreadsheet, and lubridate to work with dates. So let's import the file now and take a look at it. The first column of dates comes in as POSIX, but the ggcal function wants date objects. So I'll change my date column to date objects. That's what this is doing, using dplyr's mutate. Okay, that's better. Now I've only got a few days of the month here. If I want the entire month's calendar to print, though, I'll need to fill in the rest of the dates for the current month myself. That's what the rest of this code does. This max daily exercise day line gets the last date in my file. You can see that's January 8th. This next as date cut code finds the first day of the month for that last day in the file. That would be January 1st for any date in January. And it sets it to be a date class. Then it adds 1 month, so the result is February 1st for any date in January. I don't want February 1st, though. I want 1 day earlier than that. So I subtract 1, which means 1 day, and then I've got the end of the month, January 31st in this case. Next, I want to calculate all dates, starting with the earliest date in my data and ending with this end of the month that we just calculated. I can use BaseR's date sequencing command, creating a sequence by 1 day. I'm going to put that in a new data frame with 1 column. So why did I make a data frame of 1 column instead of just a vector? Because now I can use a dplyr left join to merge the 2 data frames. Left join means keep everything in the left or first data frame and merge it with the second data frame by a common column. I'll run that. and it joins them by day. Now my data is ready for ggcal. The syntax for the ggcal function is dates is the first argument and values is the second argument. The values can be categories like we're using now, strength training or cardio, or numbers if you want a calendar heat map. I'll run this, and you get the default calendar with default colors. I'll zoom this so you can see it better. If you want to set your own color scheme, you can use the usual ggplot2 functions. Here I used scale fill manual and added a legend name, color values for each category, and a lighter gray color for NA values. That last theme line adds back a title for the legend. Let's run that. And there's a calendar with my own colors. I've got another worksheet that includes exercise minutes in addition to categories, so you can see a calendar heat map. Let's process that. This first block of code read in the new sheet, created a new data frame with all the days of the month, and ran ggcal for minutes with the default colors. But I'd rather have the darkest color as the highest number, not the lowest. And I'd like a lighter gray for the empty block. As I said, if you know how to customize ggplot2, you can easily tweak your calendar. In this last block of code, I use rColorBrewer's scale fill distiller function to use a color brewer palette for continuous numerical data. In this case, I picked the yellow to orange to red palette. I'll zoom that, and there's the calendar with a new color scheme. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr. All lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on YouTube. Hope to see you next episode.